segment of the program is the how-to session for making personal positivity a way of life. It outlines methods for getting and keeping yourself in a resourceful state, a key element in more fully enjoying this great game we call life. We'll also share insightful information on how to carve a duck. Let's listen.
I don't know how many times I've asked the question of groups of people, how important are attitudes? And invariably I get back short, one-word answers. Very critical. Attitudes are everything. I really believe most of us subscribe to the fact that attitudes are an important part of our existence. And if that's the case, then it benefits us to take a look at how the attitude mechanism works. The way you think determines your attitudes. Attitudes are nothing more than habits of thought. Your attitudes determine your behavior, and your behavior determine the results that you get out of life. It all starts with the way you choose to think. Let me illustrate. I do a lot of driving in my business, make a lot of trips to Minneapolis, which, as you well know, is legally about an hour and a half from here. Let's say driving back from Minneapolis, I get caught up in a negative thought pattern about my wife, Pat, and our relationship. I'm driving along the highway thinking, oh boy, that little tiff we had last week. If she ever brings that up again, I'm going to tell her in no uncertain terms what I think of that. And the other day when she said, well, if she'd have done something different 5 years ago, our life sure would be different right now. Well, if I would think like that for an hour and a half, by the time I got home, my attitudes would be pretty lousy. My behavior would be cordial at best, and the results probably wouldn't be very good. What if, on the other hand, I chose to think positive thoughts? What if I thought about the love that we've shared now for 44 years, or the joy that we had in raising our family, or how going through the tough times, he was right there, right by my side, so supportive. Well, if I would think like that for an hour and a half, by the time I would get home, my attitudes would be a whole lot different, my behavior would be a whole lot different, and the results would be a whole lot different. And let me ask you this, what changed? The only thing that changed in those two scenarios is what I chose to think about, but what a dramatic difference in results. Now, we saw that working over an hour and a half. Multiply that by 5, 10, 15, 20 years. And you can see that so much of our quality of life depends on what we choose to think about. So I'd like to sell you on an idea. If somebody would come up to me and say, look, you can give one speech for the rest of your life, give it as many times as you want, but you can only give one speech, what would it be? It would be this session we're in right now, because this is a how-to session for keeping yourself positive and motivated. I would like to sell you on an idea. Set aside some time every single day to do something to put positive thoughts into your mind. We spend all kinds of time in school educating ourselves. We learn to diagram sentences. We learn to solve quadratic equations. And that's all very important. It's important to be good at what you do. But we also need to educate the attitude part of your mind. And there are a lot of ways to do that. If you enjoy reading, set aside some time every day to read good, positive materials. Get up in the morning, pour yourself a cup of coffee, glass of juice. It's nice and quiet. Take time to read and reflect. If you haven't read Zig Ziglar's book, See You at the Top, I highly recommend that you do so. In the mid-80s, I read a book entitled Love is Letting Go of Fear by Dr. Gerald Jampolsky. About 105 pages, about 45 pages of illustration. I got done with the book and I thought, boy, Jerry, you pulled one over on us. Not a whole lot of text in here. But the ideas in that book changed my life. It changed the way I was dealing with my kids. It changed the way I was dealing with my athletes. I was still coaching at the time. It began to change the way I looked at people in general. Every day we nourish our body with good, healthy food. We need to do the same thing with our minds. We need to feed it good, healthy, positive material. We are surrounded by negativity. Read the newspaper, it's negative. Listen to news on television, it's negative. Listen to a mother sending her kid off to school. Don't get run over by the bus, it's negative. We need to do something to combat that. And it is amazing what happens when you take control of your thinking.